Hello, how are you? Welcome to this new video tutorial. We're going to talk today about how to operate with an antique calculator. To do that, I have selected this wonderful Schubert calculator made in Germany in the 60s that it's in a wonderful conservation state. It's almost in mint condition. The video tutorial will have two main parts. We will learn about the parts of an antique calculator, and after that we will learn how to operate with it. We will talk about the addition, the subtraction, the division and the multiplication. If you're ready, let's go. We're going to start talking about the parts of a calculator. Although I have selected this Schubert for the video tutorial, most of the calculators are similar. We can see here the main body of the calculator, where we can find the keyboard to input data to the calculator. This is the keyboard control window, and where we can control to see the number we have entered in the machine. Also, we can find in the calculator as a part the carriage that can be moved to the left or to the right using these levers here, or these other levers here on the side. The carriage has two main windows. This window is the revolution counter window, where it will show us how many turns we have given to the crank. And this is this other window is the results window, where we see the result of the operation we are doing. The rest of the levers are most of them to reset the amounts of the windows and to put them in zero again. And well, the last part is the crank, that I guess that everybody knows what it is for. We're going to talk now about the operations in the next sections. We'll start with the addition and subtraction, that are the easiest operations we can do with a calculator, and I think the most intuitive. Well, to add, to do an addition of several numbers, we enter the number we're going to add in the keyboard, in this case 34,253. We make a turn of the crank, here we have the results, and then we enter another amount that we want to add to this one, in this case 20,110. We turn the crank one turn, and this is the amount. If we want to add another one, just we enter the new number, and then another turn of the crank, and here we have the result of our addition. To subtract, first we reset everything to zero. We enter the biggest amount to add. Let's say, for example, 42,535. We enter this amount in the results window, and then we're going to subtract a lower amount. For example, 11,362. Instead of turning the crank in the normal direction that we do to add, we're going to turn it to the opposite direction. So this is to subtract, okay? So in this case, we turn the crank once, and then the result is 31,173. The same for the rest of the numbers that we want to subtract. Let's say we want to subtract another 5,000. And something, yeah, in this case, and this is the result. It's very easy. We are going to explain now how to multiply with a mechanical calculator. Let's say that we want to multiply the number 43,758 and we want to multiply it by 6. So we enter the number in the keyboard and we turn the crank 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the result of multiplying 43,758 by 6 is 262,548. But what happens if we want to multiply by a bigger number? For example, I have prepared this here. Let's say that we want to multiply 43,758 by 6,274. We can't turn the handle 6,000 times because it would take too long to do it. So the engineers designed for this reason the moving carriage that is used for this purpose. First thing, let's reset everything to zero. We leave the same number, 43,758, and we take a look to the last number of our multiplier, that it's a 4. We check that the carriage is in the last position and we turn the crank 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we take a look to the second number, it's a 7. We move the carriage to the second position and we turn the crank 7 times. The third number is a 2. We move the carriage and we turn 2 times. And the last number is a 6. Just the same, we move the carriage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the result of multiplying 43,758 by 6,274 is 274,537,692. If you have an electronic calculator, you can see that this number is correct. Now I'm going to explain how to divide with the calculator. We are going to explain now how to divide with a mechanical calculator. We have prepared here this number. We are going to divide 635,746 by 325. The first thing we have to do is to introduce this number, the dividend, introduce it in the results window. So to do this, we select it with the numerical keyword. 635,746. We introduce it in the results number, in the results window. There it is. And now we reset the revolution counter window because the solution, the result of the division will be given in the divisions, are always given by the revolution counter window instead of the results window. Okay, so we will obtain here the results and here we will obtain the rest of the division. Okay, so first thing we have to see, okay, we have entered this number in the results window. Okay, we have reset the counter revolution window and we reset now the keyboard window to introduce the divisor that in our case is 325. Okay, first thing we have to see is that we are going to obtain a 4-digit number, okay, in our division. These groups of number, this will be the first digit, second, third, and 4-digit. So we move the carriage to the fourth position, okay. And important, for a division, We are going to do negative turns of the crank instead of positive turns of the crank that we were using, for additions and multiplications. Okay, so we will use negative turns of the crank toward us. Okay, and we have to tell the calculator, as they are negative turns, we have to tell the calculator that we are going to use negative turns, selecting the minus with this lever here. Okay, now we turn the crank until we overpass the zero. You will see what I mean. You see, we have overpassed the zero, so we go back to the prior position before overpassing the zero, this one. We move the carriage to the third position and we repeat the operation. We have overpassed, so we come back to the next one, to the prior position. We move the carriage to the second position and we repeat. You see? We have to go back always to the first position over zero. We move the carriage to the last position and again. Okay? And the result of dividing 635,746 by 325 is 1,956, and the rest of the division is 46. And this is how to divide with a mechanical calculator, and this is the end of the video tutorial. I hope you have had fun with us, and I'll see you in the next video tutorial. Goodbye.